In this video, I'm going to take a look at this very affordable mini 12 volt 100 amp hour battery with low temp protection from CYCLENBATT. This is the smallest lithium iron phosphate 100 amp hour 12 volt battery I have ever seen. And it's one of the least expensive also. Okay, so let's check what come in the box with this CYCLENBATT mini battery. We have a product manual here. Comes with that, a warranty card, and some other literature from CYCLENBATT. We have, I don't know if it's going to get focused here, but we have two different size M8 terminal studs, two long ones and two, I guess, average size ones. And here's the battery. And that is a small, that is a mini. It's the first mini I have reviewed. And it is mini. Well, that is small. Okay, so first let me tell you a bit more about this battery, and then I'll run some tests and make sure that it lives up to what the manufacturer claims about this battery. So first let me show you some quick measurements. It is 9 inches in length, 8.5 inches tall, and 5 3/8 depth. So this is a mini battery, so it's smaller than your group 24 batteries. And then, but it's quite a bit smaller than the Group 31 batteries that you often see on my channel. It weighs 20.5 pounds, and you can tell there's no wasted space in this battery here. It's solid. It looks lighter than it actually is when you go to pick it up, but it's actually only 20.5 pounds. So that's actually about a pound lighter than most of the batteries I've reviewed on this channel, if not all the batteries I've reviewed on this channel. You have here these collapsible handles, which you typically see on Group 24 and mini batteries. You have your color-coded terminal studs, M8 5/16. As mentioned, it has low temperature protection, which I'll be testing in a few minutes. And it has all the detailed specs about the battery right here on the back, so you don't have to go grab the manual if you need to. Okay, so the battery shipped at a voltage of 13.249 to 2.50. That's a little bit on the higher side, but that's not a problem. All right, let me get this thing charged up and we'll do some testing. Okay, I've got the battery fully charged. I just put on the battery capacity tester and just getting started here at a little over 10 amps, and I'll come back when we're all done. Okay, so the capacity test is completed and let's see how we did. Came in at 102.27 amp hours or 1292 watt hours. So overrated capacity. So now I'm going to do a max load test. The manufacturer claims this can do a continuous 100 amps. I'm going to do that for, let's say, 5 minutes. I've got a combination of a heat gun here and an oil heater on the floor, and I'm going to bring this up to just a little over 100 amps, and then let's run it for 5 minutes. So let me zero in here, lock this into place, and let me turn on the oil heater first. Come on now. Okay, and there goes the amps up to about almost 60, a little over 61. Let me turn on the heat gun on low. Okay, let me turn on the other side of the oil heater. There we go. Just a little over 100 amps. Let's run this for 5 minutes. Okay, no problem running for 5 minutes. Let me turn off the oil heater and the heat gun. And let's check to see there's anything warm or anything here. No, feels slightly above room temperature. Everything seems good. It passed. Okay, so now I'm going to do the max load test of what the manufacturer claims. They can do 300 amps for 5 seconds. Let's see if I can get this focused here. Yeah, if you see that right there in the middle, max discharge current, 5 seconds, 300 amps. Now, I'm pushing my limits here, so I'm not sure if I can get this done, I'll get as close as I can. But I have the oil heater in the floor, as I had before. I've got two inverters all hooked up here. And it's not a safe hookup. There's no fusing. There's nothing. This is just for a test, and I'll be disconnecting this as soon as the test is over. But I have two inverters, a 3,000 watt, 2,000 watt, and I have a heat gun and the space heater above, and of course the oil heater I mentioned. And I should be able to get us right over 300 amps, but what's going to happen is it's going to get really loud. All the fans are going to kick on. The low voltage will start beeping on this 3,000 watt inverter here. And I'm going to try and zoom in here. I've got all of the positive wires going through my clamp multimeter, and I'll try to show you the amperage there. And we'll try to hit that for 5 seconds. So hopefully I'll get this on the first shot, but this may take a few attempts. So okay, first, here we go with the heat gun. Let's turn it on low first, see what happens there. Oil heater. We have 293 amps. Let me kick it on high. I may overdo it here, but... Oh, it is on high. So, okay, I'm going to kick this on high. One. Oh. Okay. We'll try again. Okay, we're going to try again. I've turned the heat gun down just a little. And as you see, we get really close there. And I'm just going to have to count in my head when we try to, if I get 300. But okay, let's try this again. Oil heater. We are 131 amps. Heat gun. Space heater. All right. 262. Let me turn it up. 300 amps. Okay, that's 5 seconds. All right. My inverters, if they hold up, let's see, go a little bit longer here. Okay, we're pushing the limit, so I'm going to turn these things off. All right, so the battery held up nicely there. The voltage gets a little low, and one of these inverters here starts beeping low voltage alarm, and then when everything gets cut on, it both inverters beep low voltage alarm. But the battery held up, just as they said, it will hold 300 amps for more than 5 seconds. Okay, so now I'm going to do the cold temperature protection testing. So I've got it hooked up to the battery charger. Now let me turn it on just to prove that it's going to charge. And you should see that little light come on right there, say it's charging. And it is charging. So let's go stick it in the freezer. Okay, I've stuck the battery in the freezer, and hopefully it won't crush my wife's frozen dinner. So we'll keep it in here about an hour, and then we will come back, pull it out, and see if it'll charge. Okay, so I just pulled the battery out of the freezer. It's been a little over 2 hours. I tried after an hour, and it wasn't quite enough. The battery is quickly warming up, so let me quickly turn this charger on. If the battery won't allow charging, it will start to charge and then turn off. Let's see what happens. Okay, it started trying to charge, and it turned off. Okay, good. So after I pulled the battery out of the freezer, I set up a timer, and it's been almost an hour, and the battery just started charging again. So after the battery warmed up, it resumed charging, and that means that low temp charging protection does work. So based on my testing, the CYCLENBATT Mini battery performed exceptionally well. I experienced no issues, and the low temperature charge protection worked, just as described. This aligns with other positive reviews I've seen. The battery does utilize high-quality grade-A prismatic cells and is backed by an industry-standard 5-year warranty. The manufacturer claims an impressive lifespan exceeding 5,000 cycles, which translates to 10 years of reliable service. While priced competitively amongst the most affordable 12V 100Ah lithium-ion phosphate batteries I've encountered, this model stands out with valuable features often found with more expensive batteries, notably the low temperature charge protection and the compact mini form factor, which makes it ideal for space-constrained applications or colder climates. So if you're seeking a quality, budget-friendly 12V battery for confined spaces and potentially colder climates, the CYCLENBATT Mini could be an excellent choice for you. I've included the Amazon link in the video description below so you can get further details and most up-to-date pricing information. While that wraps up this video, I would like to thank CYCLENBATT for sending me this battery for my review. And if you enjoyed the video, I encourage you to press the like button so YouTube will recommend it to more people, which will really help out my channel. Thanks for watching.